Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. Before we begin, I want to just take an opportunity to thank my colleague, Professor Jonathan Walton, who is the Pusey Minister of the Memorial Church, and all his staff for their gracious hospitality in this beautiful venue that we're in today. So we appreciate your hospitality. Thank you. So my name is David Hempton, and as Dean of the Harvard Divinity School, it's my distinct honor and great privilege to welcome you, Your Holiness, 17th Karmapa, to Harvard University to speak about a topic that's very near and dear to all our hearts and minds, caring for life on earth in the 21st century. Your Holiness, we are deeply honored by your presence with us today, and to mark this historical and special visit, I have the privilege of presenting a welcoming gift to you, a memorial bowl that is engraved with our Harvard Divinity School seal, and the words, "Presented to His Holiness the 17th Karmapa with the highest appreciation on the occasion of his historic visit to the Harvard Divinity School, Cambridge, Massachusetts, March 26, 2015. So this is my pleasant responsibility. So it's my pleasure to welcome all of you, members of the entourage of His Holiness, honored lamas, faculty, students, and staff at Harvard, as well as our friends and guests from near and far, who are both physically present with us here at the Memorial Church, and also those joining us via our live web stream. A very warm welcome to everyone. Your Holiness, as you know, the Harvard Divinity School has had a long-standing, cordial, and friendly relation with important representatives of Tibetan Buddhism. In 1976, we welcomed His Holiness the 16th Karmapa to HDS, following an invitation from our Hollis Professor Harvey Cox. And on April 30th, 2009, we had the honor of hosting your mentor and teacher, His Holiness the Dalai Lama, here in this very church, on exactly the same spot we are sitting right now. Six years ago, His Holiness the Dalai Lama spoke about educating the heart was the topic, and you also have addressed this in your inspiring and beautiful book, The Heart is Noble, Changing the World from the Inside Out. I really recommend you get this book and read it. It's a wonderful read. It seems a natural continuation of this dialogue, therefore, to direct our views now to the future and to the 21st century, and we're excited to hear your thoughts on this vital topic in just a few moments. First, please allow me to say just a few words about Harvard Divinity School's important connections with Buddhism. As many of you know, HDS has had a thriving Buddhist ministry program since 2011. This program is an important part of our mission to educate leaders who are conversant in world religions, as well as ministers who can lead spiritual communities and provide guidance as religious professionals appropriate to modern global conditions. With the support of a generous gift from the Robert H. N. Ho Family Foundation, Harvard Divinity School has thus been able to expand its offerings in ministerial training to include the study of Buddhist ministry. Along with our students, the driving force behind many of these exciting developments has been my friend and colleague, Professor Janet Gyatso, the Hershey Professor of Buddhist Studies and Associate Dean for Faculty and Academic Affairs at Harvard Divinity School. We also have the honor of welcoming among our guests this afternoon the generous donor behind Professor Gyatso's chair, Mr. Barry Hershey. So a special welcome to him. Professor Gyatso and her team in academic affairs have put together today's event, and our sincere thanks go to all of you for putting this together so well. So it's now my great pleasure to welcome Professor Gyatso, herself an internationally acclaimed scholar of Tibetan Buddhism, and the author recently of a large and very important book on the history of medicine in early modern Tibet, to introduce our honored guest. So Janet, please, thank you.
Thank you very much, and good afternoon, everyone. It's an amazing honor for me to be able to introduce the great hero, His Holiness the 17th Karmapa, Ugyen Tsenle Dorje, to you this afternoon. I myself have never met him before until today, but of course I've heard so much about him, and it's really a great thrill and honor to finally meet him in person. Our speaker this afternoon is the 17th in a line of tukus, or officially recognized reincarnating lamas. Each in that line were recognized as young boys by disciples of the prior deceased Karmapa on the basis of special signs, indications, and instructional letters. The first Karmapa, Dusum Kembo, was born in 1193. He is probably the first Tibetan master to produce a recognized incarnation after his own death. This reincarnation, or recognized tuku, was the second Karmapa, Karmapakshi, who was an amazing meditator and master who spent years as a hermit. He later visited Kublai Khan, and he also met Marco Polo. The third Karmapa, Rangchen Dorje, was a brilliant theorist. He wrote about the spiritual capacities and pathways in the human body. And his magnum opus, called Sapmo Nangdun, or in English, The Profound Inner Meaning, has also been very important for my work as a scholar. The fifth Karmapa was the teacher of the Ming Emperor Chengzu, who offered to send troops to place all of Tibet under the Karmapa's rule, which the Karmapa declined. Mikyo Dorje, born 1507, wrote copiously on Buddhist phenomenology and Buddhist deconstructive metaphysics. He was also invited to visit the Chinese court, but he declined. The 11th Karmapa, Chuying Dorje, was a great and original painter and sculptor. He creatively expanded upon old art styles from both India and China. The 16th Karmapa, Rangchung Rinpa Dorje, was born in the 20th century and escaped Tibet in 1959, taking many of the Karmapa lineage's sacred treasures and relics with him. He had already composed poetry back in the 40s, foretelling Buddhism's imminent demise inside Tibet, and he realized that an important site for the future of his traditions might be the West. He went to meet Pope Paul and later set up many Buddhist centers in Europe and the United States. He died in Illinois in 1981. It is said that he was able to communicate with animals. Once, while teaching in Europe, a large raven tapped on the window where His Holiness was speaking. The bird then flew into the room and directly over to His Holiness, who then instructed two people to go to a barn a few miles down the road where they would find two birds, trapped and starving. They went, and birds were discovered there, and they rescued them. The 16th Karmapa, it was actually famous for having a special fondness for birds, and he considered a visit to the local pet shop in every city in the world an essential part of his itinerary. No doubt, he was murmuring quiet mantras and blessings to the birds when he met them. The current Karmapa is Ugyen Tsenle Dorje, the 17th Karmapa, in whose presence we are today. He is no less exceptional than any of his exceptional predecessors, or should I say his previous lives. And by the way, I would advise you to look on Google. You can search the 16th Karmapa, and you'll see a certain resemblance, at least in my opinion, a certain glow. It's very similar. Anyway, I'm here to tell you that the tuku system in Tibet is alive and well. The master and teacher before us is obvious evidence of it. Ugyen Tsenle Dorje was born into a nomad family in the Latok region of eastern Tibet in 1985. He became a monk at the age of 4, and then at the age of 7, he was recognized as the 17th Karmapa by a team of Karmakagyu lamas who were traveling around Tibet on a search team, carrying with them the prediction letter written by the 16th before he died. The signs matched, and the boy was installed at the old monastery Tsurpu in north-central Tibet, where he arrived from the east on horseback with high pomp and procession. This was in 1992. He began to be trained there to be the head of the Karmakagyu school and to take up the position that his former life had occupied. So this is the tuku system of Tibet. A special child is formed by a group of masters and monks to become a teacher of wisdom and compassion, a visionary to lead his people. And this is especially important in these times of great duress for his people. And at the age of 14, I think maybe a thunderbolt hit him, I don't know, but he realized that he needed to be outside the strict surveillance of the Chinese authorities, and instead, in the ambience of His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama and the many other high teachers who were in exile in the Indian Himalayas, he really needed to receive the necessary teachings for his education. So plans were made carefully, and one night he climbed out of an upstairs window in his monastery residence and, accompanied only by his trusted head steward, who by the way is with us today, and a few guides, he made his way across the Himalayas by car, foot, horseback, helicopter, train, and taxi to Dharamsala, India, where he showed up, none the worse for the wear, at the door of the Dalai Lama 1 week later. I remember well that day, January. January 5, 2000, when the headline hit the world press. I remember well gazing at his face in the newspaper the next day. I felt, even from that distance, the bold and intelligent and amazingly honest energy of this young man from Eastern Tibet. It was also thrilling that the Dalai Lama, the exile leader of the Tibetan people, along with the many other great lamas of Tibetan Buddhism, were reunited with another member of the really upper echelon of Tibetan Buddhist authority, the Karmapas. It was all purely a result of vision and determination that the right thing should happen, and so it did. His Holiness the 17th Karmapa did indeed continue to study in detail in India, receiving a veritable treasure trove of teachings. He has also been pursuing concerns in the larger world far beyond his study of Tibetan philosophy and religious practice. He's particularly interested in the environment, in gender issues, social justice. And much like his predecessor, the compassionate care of animals is extremely important to him, and he's living as a vegetarian for the last 8 years. He is also a playwright and a director. He wrote and produced a six-play act on the life of Milarepa, combining elements of traditional Tibetan opera and modern theater, and I really wish I could see that. I think it might be available on YouTube. Among other amazing things, he has recently announced in a very historically important act that he will convene a platform to begin ordaining women as Tibetan bhikshunis in the Mularsavasavada tradition. And this has huge, huge significance for global Buddhism today. And he's also creating green monasteries all across the Himalayan region. The Divinity School requested that His Holiness would speak to us about some of his ideas and hopes and visions for the future, his ethical concerns about the future of life on planet Earth in the 21st century today. Let me just close by saying, first of all, that His Holiness is accompanied on this tour by his elder sister, Jetsumang Mudrup Belzum, and by several senior scholars, nuns, and monks in his entourage. It is really my great honor to welcome him and his entourage to Harvard Divinity School, and the Memorial Church. Je Karmapa Keno Tuche Sik.
Harvard First, I'd like to greet everyone here at my first visit to Harvard University and Harvard Divinity School. I want to greet all of you, professors, aspiring scholars, students, and everyone who's here.
지다당에 인지디 인지 탭자르 인지 차교 지디 갑 갑신 거라 다 임비네야 디 하버드 라브르 시민디디 나로레 갑아드데 갑로아드데 지제면도 제자 아니 가수래다 아줄이야 기규 야보지 제자 안데 기규디 규네 야보지 저한테 스테라 겹시다
I can actually speak some English. I feel that I speak it somewhat poorly. I certainly don't think my English is up to Harvard standards. So therefore, I brought a translator.
The wonderful translator, I think. Gyalwang Karmapa Kunjichudrupa Ta Amirgaliya Pebre Yazizena Peg Nama Sange Bege Takatureji Lama Chimbu Teneji, Chige, Nujolia, and Chisho Zedin Benge, Nashu Dujikte, Tuchadiore, and Chesa on de Peche, Havilia Dus Nabre. Chesa Dagi Kong Jisun Mate, Maji Jabuji or Domad Javier, Kashing Alia Discord, Kazadi. The
I did plastic surgery. That looks like a little bit. That is kind of junk.
Takanda yangar yangar dilia nyonto bichuma de gab sha chungs ane adana singi azu phege ala me buti kos jangwe chumu cho de phese takanda diji gi da lugyu gi gyurim yede du simi hindustane dide ching dine dus dina lo lia nabad misen gi
As Professor Gyamtso mentioned, the 16th Gyalwang Karmapa came to the United States as one of the first Tibetan Buddhist masters to bring the Tibetan Buddhist teachings to Western countries, and during that time did indeed, as she said, visit Harvard University. She remarked that my face resembles his, perhaps I've had plastic surgery in order to make it so. And then he said that's a kind of joke.
Some people say.
But in any case, whether I resemble my predecessor or not, I'm very, very glad to be back here. And also in consideration of the, that I'm following on a previous visit by His Holiness, the Dalai Lama, to this very church.
That Zirim di Gatu Din Zirim de Mamushi, Tanasha Wen and Tawatsavishi, and Mamushi, and the Togong on that and the Gisha would use that D. There's kind of too much, some of the same distancing the child, Dina Lolia, and the Gisha was in his Kabush Charlie to the Imbina Kandaria. And during Asia, the topic, the human singing, during his chief in Nalolia, the bullying gave that is social summer with Kendro, social Namia, Kashura Daji, Simguru Sanandrado, Yanaji, Telia, Karaslav, take care of care of condition, as I did, Jersey Tier and David on Jay.
I've had a busy day, actually a little bit too busy, especially when you consider that the my main thing today was to come here and address all of you at this talk. But nevertheless, I will do my best to address the topic you've presented, how to care for life, living things, on Earth, this planet, in the 21st century.
Sidang
나바상게베 니추에나가다 프린시플스 말베 지 닝부르 지데 가라스나 안 딘중기 다와스나 잔도 야나 딘중기 다진타시아티 차리 어르섬트비
To start with, the real essence of the Buddha's teachings is interdependence, the view that everything is interdependent.
이내야 디 인터디펜던스야 디 따와당 뜨루당 야나지 신이리고 some philosophical 다든지기 신이리베기 신이리고 좀 다들 컨디션이 아주 미진하로리아 진제비다 간다 딘중기 진단디 미진하로 컨디션 제제 냠수 레아당 다나 신기 엔더지 bring it to emotional level 세나다도 간다지스 티 심속 돌에 컨디션 제제 엔디 딘중기 에지 진단디 컨디션 삼동고사디 가장 개심부지 통해
But I think it's extremely important that we not leave the doctrine or idea of interdependence as a mere philosophical idea, but that we actually ask ourselves the question, how can I live according to interdependence? How can I apply interdependence in my life, including my emotional life?
소셜 미디어에 다나 신기 지 인포메이션 에러스 요아레 체팅 드립스 요아레 제선 디나로리 양아주 체팅디 팅디기 추제 되네 응 좀블링베디 찌글 찌데인 임바디 응알레갸 응세 되드 심바지다 넘버 세르 심바지 임바지 아주 참에 신기하다
We can all surely observe that in this 21st century through social media and other technologies, in this era of information, as we call it, in our mutual interdependence is even more obvious than ever before.
In a logic information, somewhere where that is, Nizu Kashura Daji Manguchi Antulia Manguchi have a DGB, Pingy Alman, Samsam. 아주 그냥 아주 사벌해야지. Inform more information we get, 다 우연히 주디 아주 지세로 잘로 저와 차별해 되냐? 직전에 우연히 주 털어야 되는데 뭐 마찬가지지. 우연히 주 털어야 information 망한. 아주 뒤 꾸준 준 조기에 그렇지. 머리가 잘로 그렇지. 이제 전화용도.
However. Information alone is not enough. Well, from one point of view, we might say that the more information we have, the clearer our situation becomes. Sometimes we have so much information that it's too much, and it actually obscures us and prevents us from understanding our situation.
Information Understanding, Lebenang, understanding the mind, the Ningan Senator Kanda, she knew you saw an alarm. Kandesia Lalenta was Adi, Gesim Chichadi.
So interdependence is not just about the sharing of information or an understanding we might arrive at in our brains, in our heads. It is about sharing the feelings in our hearts. And about our real experience.
Tada di penge chungdu kauke sonar shevin. A chungdu sane ta losum si kap tware. Ti kablia azu payulia ane springtime man. Dongas spring way. Hello.
Tonga Adam
Radio. Adam. Adam. I thought he's asleep. Autumn day.
Larry.
Tatanga chica caricaba mendo. Ada payulia. And it was a drawing in some. 근데 내가 칼에 칼아 쪼르디 샤 샤치기와레 제자 샤 인주자는 아주기 고소서만 심지엔들레 아주 잠잠데 또 뒤주지리야디 심지세요레 이 심지세베 거리야 아주 심지세단디 아주 베 심지세단다 디 디지 가르쉬에 팩토리 디즈 지라나 지 많이 받다 간다 지 심지세란데 레라버지 아마 야마나 지 가르쉬다 지 제자 마셰디 심지 카드 받담 지 지셔바 데 레라버 시원 심지 레라버 마셰체 우마나 버지 주주 삼서 주주 제가 좀 고우면 좀 야버지 정면 다 간다 시부지 고우 디즈 어떻게 들어 예비체 데 수부 참아 응이나
做什么困难就是东西，我想说需要嘞。第六，甚至是那个了，他在俺那时候不成个多。第六，咱那边是，得了麻烦不了不起，人了麻烦不了不起，吃完了不起，打瞌睡了，年纪现在这个没得，年纪现在的俺这个，那么就这个，南边给写的啊，这年纪这个，忙不起写的啊，这年纪也没得好过嘛的。但现在，咱这下面就专门买一边，就没说吧。
那那些，人家俺给用的啊，不是用的。但是呢，各地的水土地的些什么的，甚至的些在包括水产，像，呀，像粮食的，这样下手了吧？就不你看你们多，那各地的山呢，他们说，你农民的是俺活活当起，甚至设备高，俺体力远了，那得俺就就是disturb起来噻，他们说活活当起就体力，嗯，但这个你就做不来。
I can remember an experience that I had as a child when I was 3 or 4, where I was living then. In the autumn, as nomads, we would have to slaughter some animals since we relied upon meat as one of our principal sources of food. Now, nomads, of course, don't get their meat in a market that's been slaughtered in a factory. You have to do it yourself, and it's not easy. Mostly, it was done by my family. They would bind the mouth.
No, not my family. Somebody
by the community.
Hiding something.
Oh.
Mostly, yeah. Okay.
Okay. Mostly, it was done by
other people
binding the jaws or mouth of the animal so it would slowly suffocate. Now, this is an agonizing way to kill an animal, as it takes, at least in my memory, almost half an hour sometimes. For the animal to die. Before it's dead, it's covered in sweat from its agony and slow suffocation. And I clearly remember this, and I remember the way I would feel as a young child watching this. I had an unbearable feeling in my heart. I wouldn't want to call it compassion. I don't know if what I felt then corresponds to a strict definition of compassion or not. But it was a very intense feeling. So that it got to the point where when the slaughtering was going to occur, they would trick me and send me somewhere else so I wouldn't be around and wouldn't disturb them doing it.
Did you send that book to Jurubje? No educated Samarwe. And Dana Singhi, not much knowledge, someone, did you? In a 그러나게도 qualities of the church of the Indian is to be Shivuji Yagachi, get some of the Tingro, the Mimavaji. Tai Bine, near those parts with Chidi alone, some of the Nusan. Gasha Chimi does some of the Kanislava, go back to see some of the Manizu, Nizu Samadambe Kala. Go to Jugi, near Chunjun Gogi, German Mayimbam, Semi, Ninji Tendroji.
philosophical reason that the mangbo ji xian de yore de ina ngoma de ne xingi ji kashure de be really sorry ji jue mo mo yin ba ji da da na xin sue de me ba ji tin de ji yong a de ngoma ne xi ju a ka bu chi se za de jun zen de ne ye ka du ne ya ge ji ju chun jun ge ge jue mo mo yin bi da sen bu chuan na de le that really appreciated son san an da do I miss that so ma ro da de ji ji
Now, remember that at that time, at the age of 3 or 4, I was a very young boy with no education whatsoever and not much knowledge or experience of things. But nevertheless, I had this natural and genuine feeling of sorrow and compassion. Well, at the age of 7, I was recognized as the Karmapa and put on a high throne and began to receive a very thorough education. Now, people usually, when they think of the Gyalwang Karmapa, they think of someone who must have tremendous spiritual qualities. But I have to say to you that when I think back and remember the unfabricated compassion I felt for those slaughtered animals as a young and uneducated child, I miss that degree of genuine, unfabricated feeling. And I think that in some ways, it surpasses the compassion that I can generate now through lots of education and thought and so on. And therefore, I really appreciate the memory of that uneducated compassion I had as a child, and I miss it.
Also, man muss sich lange gehen. Chamzi, Nubasan und Rando, Chamzi, Yende, also lange, Yonde, Abuji. Denn es ist so, Kashi ist so, Buji, Muyon, und Titili, Buji, da, der Muyon, das ist so, die Hagu, die Gile, Zorn und Singe, alles, das ist so. Kann da ja, die Mitschibo, mein Eben, die Tundula Service, im Sinne des Dungen, was schon wissen.
I think that children, especially very young children, have an innate capacity for genuine love and loveliness. For example, how often have we all seen that when one child is crying, another child will immediately start crying as well, because they recognize the feeling and they naturally sympathize with it and share it. I think we're all capable of this, not just with other human beings. I think our sympathy can extend to all living beings, including animals. And I don't think this has anything to do with whether we regard ourselves as spiritual or not, or whether we are educated or not. I think it is an innate part of being human.
Thank you, And kashmeji grown up samarwe kada langsur ge yon jistane azu chochi ne ne kar kashmeta ji yon de chhar ro sa orda chochi ne ta nga careful de chat da ya kan kashwa dizen go de bon de chat ta ta de chwa na sam dang de ne chat sa nan de ji ge thon da kan da I mean,
as we grow up, we are subjected to various changes in our environments and circumstances, and I think that these can cause our innate compassion to become obscured. It's almost as though we're born with the compassion button switched on and it gets switched off. Because as adults, now we need to think about it. It doesn't come as easily to us. And when we think about the suffering of another and the possibility of taking responsibility for helping them, we always think, well, would doing so harm me or help me? How would it affect my life? In one way, this is because we are, as we like to say, grown up. We're educated, and we're therefore careful, even clever, maybe strategic. And so we're clever enough to think, well, this doesn't involve me. I don't feel connected to that. And also to worry about the risk that we might be posing to ourselves by feeling compassion for others. And I think all of this tends to obscure or repress our innate love and compassion.
She says, Ninji Sadi, not to think of Ninji Samara, Ninji Samadama, to generate some of the change. The Indusane, that the Yomber Shevala, as encouragement. That is Ninji Shevore Saji, Maima, and Ninji Chendu Gitakanda. Cartwright, voluntarily, some of the dedicated Yana, she swims you down.
Compassion, after all, is not a thought, it is a feeling. And it's not something that we can really inculcate or even encourage particularly. Compassion is something that each of us has to volunteer through our natural courage and benevolence. And that benevolence is really the root of compassion.
The Indusane, Azu de Tangi Shubana Singi, Azu Tinjung Tawas and Dandu, and the Tawa Chibu Mahima Takanda Tinjung in Tasade, Mizina Loliang Azu, the Musu Azu Yamsu Yoya de Stakanda, Chigitilia and Jabachadi Evici. Simsi jig And it Simjin Shengi Nedan Serendrando, Simjin Shengi, that didu di Susugi didu chashi and Chadiot. Tindi imidun zen dene and Rangi Nangi, Jing Gang Kuriag Samlo Gang Kundu somebody Tindijig Kashweta, Nedan of D 당 고쳐버서 난 다도 당 고쳐버 집은 평가면도 가다디 내당 들려야지 오늘 전에 쓰면이 냠수 영화로지 깨왜 토하네 아니 신의지 가수에 기운 구르기 나 다들 이제 닝도부터 대비 닝지지 깨토야지 닝지 대한 닝도부터 대비 닝지 다들 이제 깨토야지 영화
As I said, interdependence, while it is a concept or an idea, must be more than an idea or a look or view. It has to be something that we experience. We need to experience and recognize the interdependence of this environment and all of the beings who inhabit it, and the interdependence among beings, between any one being and all others. The food we eat, the clothes we wear, the air we breathe, has all arisen through the actions of other beings. We cannot survive independently. We cannot eat, wear clothes, or breathe independently. The more keenly we feel this, the more we will feel that the welfare or well-being of other beings, their happiness and suffering, is very much part of our own. And that will help us begin to take responsibility for the welfare of other beings. But it's not enough simply to begin or set about taking such responsibility. We have to actually feel within us the type of compassion that is genuinely courageous.
And younger than the Javaji Shui, just that, not you go to Sanish, thank you, Shivanaji. Shasa Yare, Tanaji, Shalakawish. Tisa, Mikasin, I get you to do. You're on Kala, her goes. Ta Kala, her goes, Ladisan, that shall go away, you said, or is it the Kobena town, and the Tadashasa Romero? And then that shall go away, Lamne Choske, maybe. Did Lamne Shaki issues in case of Kinsar. And then you sane that dinner. And did she is Yaral Lene? And it got a shasa, some shasa, daddy, so the Azuman, Manguchi, Azu shasa, the ardina, shaddy, condition of the day, shaddy condition of the day, Mashrava, Mamuchi, Tunguoma. That and Gideon, Flower the Bena G. Casual Tongir, Yagazin, Tongirjin, and all that, shaddy, some of the market, none of the Nyohandra, baggage, Cheshire. That the Caneon, Caneomi, near watching about the Puchin is Hagoim. That the Pajit market in the Suez key on matters of such. Mother, this same change, you have a chair, Deva, say any. The nature of the Abbot, my watching domer.
To return to my experience as a child, I ate meat, and actually, I liked meat. Quite a lot. Sometimes, even now, people will say, what's your favorite food? And if I were to answer honestly, my favorite food would still be meat, but I can't say that because I gave up eating it. I don't eat it. So I stopped eating meat several years after arriving in India. And part of the reason for this is that if you think about it, most of us who eat meat never really see where the meat we eat comes from, especially if you live in a large city in a developed nation. You probably buy your meat in a supermarket, and it's packaged in plastic and so on, to the extent that a small child that goes to such market would probably imagine that meat is a thing that they make there in that supermarket. And there's no sense that it's the body of an animal.
Then, Oma, Nidolo Lever, Gahal Lever, did you say that? 제자 아메리카네 용게다 저거도 좀 아토아요. 근데 두장 아샤스 거로. 저라 아메리카 레스 왔다. 바베큐 아버지 대인서. 오늘 바베큐 배신 보라 바베큐 대인서. 땅에 바베큐디 고데로. 네돈 젤이야. 신이 아메리카 레브레. 드디어 아샤스. 자. 근데 바베큐 사줘. 바베큐 로 젤 고데로 이나다. 지금 오늘 아메리카 레스잖아. 드디샤 사사 마네. 샤 미사야 담자 체자라. 바베큐 사도.
When I
was in America, I did a langa, the Texas barbecue in the tons. Sam in the ta. Don't you show the Irish?
When I arrived in India in the year 2000, and I met several American friends who would say, well, when you come to the United States, we'll offer you barbecue. We have this amazing way to cook meat in our country called barbecue. And you. Well, by the time I got here, the first time in 2008, I'd already committed to never eating meat again. And so it was too late. So I never actually got to taste barbecue. But I would be driven along highways and I'd see Texas barbecue on the side of the road. And it would make me salivate, but it's too late.
Also, Tinduki, Soy Nella, Chicene, Chicago, Comfort Summer, Lella, Chin, Dub, Der Chin, Chosene, Nizu Cashin as Tungo, Tangitianasi. When Nizu Cashi, did he shut his room? Sad and also you are in a massacre only, did you dream the step? The Caribbean as a Tungo. The indigence and then awareness, Marvata, the Jiggy Cashwaji. The interdependent awareness go hardy, she was a cash machine, shadding yourself something.
Nowadays, while from one point of view we're made extremely comfortable by the way we do things, the way we do things also conceals a great deal from our sight, such as the process that culminates in the meat we eat. And so we lose an awareness of our connection to things, and that we have to therefore deepen our awareness of our interdependence.
The Hindustan Dapaji Kedri Shia, the Tigazu Yimata, Akana the Hindustan, the Keshishu, the Kandara Ninji Sadi Kaja Apathy Summary, that in Zumuning Tolia. Disaster, somewhere, the disaster, disaster, tell a danger, and the in a deep disaster, the Karasana Chicana, Nazo, the Yamdo, Yedemsi, Nazo Hamaochi, Apatizad, Mazuki, Semlia, Niazi, the Yemsi. They did disaster, Shanans of Shadi. They turned the negative with the zoo, as to avoid shit who are it. In a Tindig disaster, Susugi, Semlia, Yinza, and they avoid Shadi, Kabshu Chigore. Just a digging Zen and Tammy. Responsibility, interdependent responsibilities, heavy burden of
That's more or less all I'm going to say, but I want to leave you with one thought. When we talk about having compassion regarding the many disasters that occur in this world, usually we think of things such as horrific epidemics, wars, violence, starvation, and so on. But there is one source of disaster that we often fail to recognize, which is a lack of love. A lack of love can cause people to have no help when they need help, and no friend when they need a friend. So in a sense, the most dangerous thing in the world is apathy. We think of weapons, violence, warfare, and disease as terrible dangers, and indeed they are, but we can take measures to avoid them. But once our apathy takes hold of us, we can no longer avoid it. So I urge you to feel a love that is courageous. Not courageous in the sense of the grudging undertaking of a heavy burden in feeling responsible for the welfare of others, but the joyous acknowledgement of your interdependence with every other living being and with this environment itself.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.